Submersible well pumps come in 2 and 3 wire configurations. So what does this mean exactly, and which one better suits your application? Firstly, both types feature a ground wire, which shouldn't be counted. 2-wire pumps will have 2 black wires and a green wire. 3-wire pumps have a black, red, yellow, and green wire. The basic difference between 2-wire and 3-wire well pumps is characterized by where the starting components for the motor are located. 3-wire well pumps house the starting components, such as the starting capacitors, running capacitors, relays, and thermal overloads, in a control box or panel. Control boxes are usually mounted on a wall above ground. Though the potential for failure of the parts inside the panel is greater than a 2-wire, the components can be easily accessed and cheaply repaired or replaced. For example, if a capacitor malfunctions on a 3-wire, just the capacitor itself will need to be replaced. 2-wire well pumps do not use a control box. All the elements already come built within the motor or pump house itself. This allows for easier installation. However, if any of the starting components fail, the pump will have to be pulled up and the whole motor will have to be replaced. The likelihood of component failure in a 2-wire system is much lower than a 3-wire, although it is a much more expensive and time-consuming endeavor if a part does fail. At the end of the day, it's up to you to determine the more convenient approach for your application. Your circumstances may dictate one configuration over the other, as a control box is necessary to start heavier motors. All motors that are more than 1.5 horsepower require 3-wire configurations. For any questions about your pump, or if you're in need of a pump, repair part, or accessory, visit our website, pumpproducts.com, or call our experts at 1-800-429-0800.